very, very warm welcome to All Saints this afternoon for Mohan and Natalie's wedding. I hope you all had a good journey here and the weather's held up for us. I was slightly concerned yesterday morning. I thought, I'm not sure how it's going to be, but I think we're all fine. So a couple of bits of housekeeping before we begin. If you've got a mobile phone on you, could you make sure you turn it off? You said brilliantly. Also, if you've got a camera on you, we have an official photographer who's wandering around. Can he just be the only person to take photographs, otherwise it sometimes ruins the shots for them. So that's the first thing. Secondly, if you have any confetti on you, if you throw it out in the car park, that would be great. Don't throw it in the church, otherwise somebody, I.e. me, gets to clear it up. So out of the car park, it will naturally disappear into the pond. And then finally, on your way out, you'll see there is a very, very unsubtle large bronze bowl. If you'd like to make a donation to the work of this church, that would be very grateful. A lot of people don't feel like they've really come to church unless they've given money, but I want you to have that sensation today. So do feel free to give that away. So we're going to begin with our first hymn, which is in your ordinary service, Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven. The gift of marriage brings husband and wife together in the delight and tenderness of sexual union. joyful commitment to the end of their lives. It is given as the foundation of family life, in which children are born and nurtured, and in which each member of the family, in good times and in bad, may find strength, companionship and comfort, and grow to maturity in love. Marriage is a way of life made holy by God and blessed by the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ, with those celebrating a wedding in Cana in Galilee. Marriage is a sign of unity and loyalty, which all should uphold and honour. It enriches society and strengthens community. No one should enter into it lightly or selfishly, but reverently and responsibly in the sight of Almighty God. Natalie and Mohan have to enter this way of life. They will each give their consent to the other and make solemn vows. And in token of this, they will each give and receive a ring. We pray with them that the Holy Spirit will guide and strengthen them, that they may fulfill God's purposes for the whole of their earthly life together. First, I am required to ask anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. The vows we are about to take are to be made in the presence of God, who is judging all of those in the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now. The answer to this is a nice amount of fine word.
I will.
Not yet. He's eager. Mohan Raj, will you take Natalie to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour her, protect her? Forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as we both shall live.
I will.
Very good. This is my will. Natalie, will you take my Raj to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him? And forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live.
I will.
This is your chance now, and as for now, we will. Will you, the families and friends of Natalie and Mohan Raj, support and uphold them in their marriage now and in the years to come?
We will.
Good. Let us pray. God our Father, from the beginning you have blessed creation with abundant life. Pour out your blessings upon Natalie and Mohan Raj, that they may be joined in mutual love and companionship, in holiness and commitment to each other. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We now have our two readings. Our first reading is taken from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith, so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends, but as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child, I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. But now faith, hope, and love abide. These three, and the greatest of these is love. Our second reading is called "I Belong in Your Arms" by Deborah Burdett. I belong in your arms. Finally, I have found a place in which I fit perfectly, safely and securely with no doubts, no fears, no sadness, no tears. This place is filled with happiness and laughter, yet it is spacious enough to allow me the freedom to move around, to live my life and be myself. This wonderful place which I never believed really existed, I have found finally, inside your arms, inside your heart, inside your love. Two very beautiful readings to remind us of the purpose of marriage and why we're all here today. Now, one of the key things that you should always remember when you're getting married is that you're going to now spend the entirety of your lives in close proximity to each other. What this means is that you will have to deal with the various odd and strange things that other people do. How many people here are married or in a long-term relationship? Put your hands up. That's a good, solid amount. That's very good. So you will probably know that other people, the more time you spend with them, do very strange, odd things. And when you first meet, everybody pretends that they're perfectly normal, and you go on a date. You hide the strange and odd things you do. You try and make it look like you're a normal and rational human being. And then, if you carry on dating after a while, you kind of show them a little bit. You kind of just test. You say, oh, by the way, I do this. And you see if they've run away. If they don't run away, you think, aha, I can show them a bit more. Let me tell you now, after 12 years of marriage, it doesn't stop. The obvious just becomes stranger every day. This is just going to carry on forever. And for those of you who've been married for a very long time, you will now realise that it is very difficult to change other people. They are mostly what they are. One of the joys of marriage is actually you get into the sense of that long-term commitment to each other, which goes beyond the supervision, it goes beyond what you first see, it gets into who you really and truly are. And what, of course, you do in marriage is you give it yourselves over and over again. But that's essentially what we're talking about today. The vows that you've made, the declarations you've made, and the vows you're about to make are all about giving everything of yourself and holding nothing back. Now, that doesn't mean you're going to become the same person. You don't have to buy identical jackets, you don't have to dress your children in the same clothes, in a dog and if it looks like you and all the rest of it. You can still maintain your identities. But forevermore, whenever they think of you, they will think of Natalie. Whenever they think of you, they will think of Mother Raj. So I think we're ready for our next hit. So, we're going to stand to see all things bright and beautiful, loud and with gusto.
Oh, okay.
this day forward, for better or for worse,
for richer or for poorer,
in sickness and in health,
to love and to cherish,
till death us do part, according to God's holy law, in the presence of God. Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to Mother Raja and Natalie, the symbol of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day through Jesus Christ our Lord. Presence of God and for this congregation, Natalie and Mohan Raja give their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put aside. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, for you have created joy and gladness, pleasure and delight, love, peace and fellowship. Pour out your abundance of your blessing upon Natalie and Mohan Raja and their new life together. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts and a crown upon their heads. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, awake and asleep, in joy and in sorrow, in life and in death. Finally, in your mercy, bring them to that banquet where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully grant you the riches of his grace, that you may please him in both in body and soul, and living together in faith and love, may receive the blessings of eternal life. Amen. We're going to stand up to sing our final hymn, Morning Has Broken. kneel for our prayers. In our prayers, when I say, Lord of life and love, you respond, hear our prayer. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. Faithful God, holy and eternal, source of life and spring of love, we thank and praise you for bringing Mohan Raj and Natalie to this day, and we pray for them. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. May their marriage be life-giving and lifelong, enriched by your presence and strengthened by your grace. May they bring comfort and confidence to each other in faithfulness and trust. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. May the hospitality of their home bring refreshment and joy to all around them. May their love overflow to neighbours in need and embrace those in distress. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. May they discern in your word order and purpose for their lives, and may the power of your Holy Spirit lead them in truth and defend them in adversity. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. May they nurture their family with devotion, see their children grow in body, mind, and spirit, and come at last to the end of their lives with heart content and in joyful anticipation of heaven. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. We join together to say the words of the Lord's Prayer, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Well, we're going to go make all of this legal now, so if you'd like to pop your bride up and make your way into the Lady Chapel. If all the witnesses and everybody who needs to be in the Lady Chapel make their way there, the organist is going to be playing a piece of music for us, so if you could listen quietly and offer up prayers and thanksgivings for Natalie and Mohan Raj.